Are we rolling?
We're rolling. And once again, you're watching Dean and Dale on KMAS.
KMAS TV.
Exactly. Little did you know that we had a KMAS TV.
I did not know that.
New today.
Oh, that's true. That's right. All right. HD, by the way. Notice.
So we're here at Wainuchi Lake. Wainuchi Lake is located in Grays Harbor County, just over the Mason County line, near what used to be Camp Grisdale.
Yes, and I have got to see Wainuchi Lake at a new angle, and I've been coming to Wainuchi Lake since 1971-ish, and so this is a brand new view, a new vista, thanks to my pal Dean here, who brought me through a real back way. But by golly, destination accomplished.
And I'll bet that our viewers did not know that you can start out in the Skokomish Valley,
right,
and travel all the way to the ocean without ever getting on a real highway.
Without ever hitting the asphalt.
And we're doing that today.
We're working our way that way. We're going west, young man and women.
So what you're seeing here is Wainuchi Lake. The Wainuchi Dam was started in about 1969, finished in about 1972. It's a flood control operation for, you know, the Montesano Valley and that sort of thing that used to flood every year in the winter and dry up every spring. And so now they have a constant water flow through there, and things are a lot better for them.
Yep. The Wainuchi Valley, very fertile, a lot of dairy farming down through there. And it's a little bit more regulated and a little bit more consistent for sure. And, of course, they got a great camping area now and a recreation area at Wainuchi Lake, a result of the dam that was built. In 69 through 72. So
great recreational opportunities here.
Yeah. So this is a very special event, very, very fun trip that we're having, and I hope you're enjoying some of the vistas that we're presenting to you this afternoon.
And we just want to share some of the magnificent vistas that we have in Mason and Grays Harbor counties. Ooh. If you just know where to go. And the other thing I'd like to point out, Dale, is that, you know, this is all second growth timber.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when I was a teenager, I worked up here and helped build some of these roads and helped log some of this timber up here, and now look how it's grown back.
Yeah, and so you were around for the first growth.
Yes.
Those
are some mighty big logs. You don't see those anymore.
This second growth, though, is getting close to maybe being considered for another cut. So I'm maybe a few years away, but still, cut down on a lot of our views because of the growth of the trees that have sprung up now. It is always sustained yield, as we mentioned before, and everything gets replanted, and it's farming. It's just on a longer scale.
And this was part of the Grisdale working circle between 1946 and 1985, and this area is still actively being harvested in places up here, but not to the level it was. You know, 1946 through 1985.
It was a heyday, to be sure. So we'll be back with more. But for now, this is Dean Bird and Dale Hubbard, KMAS-TV, signing off.
And back to you, back to the station.
Beautiful.
Back to you at the station.
Back to you at the
station.